Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can create a menu bar in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. All right, people, let's dive into this. So I have two classes, a main class and then a MyFrame class. MyFrame extends JFrame, so it behaves exactly like a JFrame. It also implements the action listener interface. And within my main class, I just have a new instance of MyFrame. And within the constructor of MyFrame, I have four lines of code: this.setDefaultClose operation, JFrame exit on close, this.setSize, set this to whatever size you want. I just picked 500 by 500. this.setLayout, I'm using a new flow layout, and this.setVisible set to true. And then also make sure you have an action performed method. So let's begin. To create a menu bar, we first need to create the menu bar. Then we add separate menus or tabs, kind of like what we have at the top here with our IDEs. There's different tabs that you can navigate to. And there are also menu items that you add to each of these tabs, to each of these menus. So let's begin by creating the menu bar to actually be as the container to contain all of these menus and menu items. So let's create a JMenuBar, and we will call this menu bar equals new JMenuBar. And then instead of adding this to the frame, we set it. So type in the name of the frame you're using. For me, it's just this. So this.setMenuBar. And we place the name of the menu bar within this method. That's set JMenuBar, by the way. All right, so let's try this. All right, so nothing is currently visible. That's because we have to add menus to this menu bar, kind of like what we have at the top of our IDEs. So let's create menus for file, edit, and help. So these are JMenus. JMenu, let's call the first menu file menu equals new JMenu. And then you can either set some text or pass this to the constructor. I will just say file. And let's do the same thing for edit and help. So we have an edit menu that says edit, and a help menu that says help. Now with these menus, we add them to the menu bar. We don't set them. So we type in the name of our menu bar, menu bar dot add. Then we're going to add these individual menus. So we're going to add the file menu first, followed by the edit menu, then help menu. So edit menu and then help menu. And now these should be visible. So you can see here, here's our menu bar, and here are the individual tabs or menus. However, if we were to click on these, there's no menu items. So let's add a few items to our file menu. So these are menu items. So let's declare these. Let's say we want a menu for, well, menu item for save, load, and exit. So these are JMenu items, and we'll call the first one load item equals new J menu item, and we will set some text either by using the set text method or just pass this into the constructor. So this will be load. Then we'll want a few others for save and exit. So this will be save item, and the text will be save, and exit item, and the text will be exit. So then with these items, we add them to the menu that we want. Let's say we want to add these to the file menu, so we type in the name of our file menu, kind of like what we did with our menu bar. So file menu dot add load item. So this is a menu item, and we'll repeat the process for save item and exit item. So save item and exit item. And I'm just going to group these together so it's easier to read. All right, so this is what we got so far. We have our menu bar, we have our menus, they kind of function like tabs. We don't have anything added to help or edit. I don't really think we'll need to, but with file, there's actually a drop-down menu, and we can select one of these items to perform some sort of task for us. So let's use our action listener interface to actually have these perform some sort of task for us. So we need to add an action listener to each of these menu items. So let's add them here. So load item dot add action listener. Since we're implementing an action listener interface, we can just pass in this. And we'll repeat this process for the save item and the exit item. So save item and exit item. So now these will respond to clicks if you were to click on them. However, we need to state what we want them to do within the action performed method. So let's just do this with some if statements. So if e.getSource is equal to our load item, we will pretend that we're loading a file. So system.out.println. I think I mistyped this. There. We'll display a message. Beep, boop, you loaded a file. All right, but within our action performed method, it does not recognize this load item component. So we need to declare these outside of our constructor because right now they are only local. So anything within the constructor, within these sets of curly braces, actually recognize what this is. So let's declare all of these items, all of these components outside of our constructor. So that's JMenuBar, and we do not need to declare this twice. I could have done this for the beginning, but I think it's easier to understand if I just declare everything all together, and then we fix this later. So give me one moment to fix these. So that's our edit menu, our help menu, and then we will probably want to declare the items as well outside of the constructor. So we have load item, save item, and exit item. Actually, I think I'm just going to copy all these and get rid of most of these lines here. There we go. All right, so our action performed method now recognizes this load item component. And let's just create a few other if statements. There's more elegant ways of writing this, but this is something really simple for us beginners. So let's say if e.getSource equals save item, we will display beep boop you saved a file. And then lastly, we have exit item. So it's the same process as before. So exit item. Actually, why don't we have our program actually exit? So in order to do that, it is system.exit, and then you can just pass in 0. All right, so this will now respond to events. So here's our menu bar, each of the menus, and here are the menu items. So if we click load, it's going to pretend that we're loading a file. File, save, you have saved the file, and then exit. Exit will actually work because system.exit will close out of your program. One feature available to us is that we can set keyboard shortcuts for all of the menu items and the menus. So in order to do that, we use the set mnemonic method. So let's add that perhaps here. So let's begin with the different menu items. So we type in the name of the menu item we want to add a mnemonic to. So that is, let's say, load first. So load item dot set mnemonic. It's spelled kind of funky. So set mnemonic, and then we add a key event. So key event dot, and then the key that we want to set for this shortcut. So let's say we want L for load. So that would be VK underscore capital L. So I'll add a comment here. So this is L for load. And let's set a few others for save and exit. So save item, set mnemonic, key event, then S, make sure that's capital S, for load. So S for load, and then exit. So that is exit item, key event, how about E? E4 exit. Let me fix that. All right, let's try this. So we still need to navigate to the specific menu where these are contained. But if you look at each of these menu items here, they are underlined with their keyboard shortcut. So if I were to type L, it's going to load a file, S to save, and then E to exit. And you can do the same thing for the individual menus as well. So let's set a mnemonic for those. I'm just going to group these together. So we have file menu, edit menu, and then help menu. So let's say F-E-H to match the file or the different menu names. So that's F, E, and then H. However, for these menus, you need to hold Alt plus whatever key. So that's Alt F for file, and then Alt E for edit, and Alt H for help. Probably change these as well. So Alt F for file, Alt E for edit, and Alt H for help. And let's give this a go. Now I'm not going to use the mouse cursor at all. I'm going to use my mnemonics that I set up. So if I want the help menu, that is Alt H. Edit is Alt E. File is Alt F. And then to select one of the menu items, I don't need to hold Alt. I just select the letter. So you can actually see that they're underlined too. So load is just L. I need to go back to the file if I want to select something else. So that is Alt F. Then S for save. Alt F again to go back to file, and then E for exit. All right, so let's also set some icons for each of these menu items. So I have a few icons that I want to use for load. I just have a folder, save is a floppy disk, and exit is a door because I think that's appropriate. So I'm going to create some image icons, but I'm going to declare these outside of our constructor. So image icon, I will call the first one load icon. And then I want a save icon and exit icon. So this is save icon. And then exit icon. And I'm going to instantiate these within the constructor. So load icon equals new image icon. Then the file path or the file name. Since these are within the same project folder, I just have to use the file name. I don't need the full file path. So for load icon, I'm going to use load.png and repeat the process for save and exit. So save icon, save.png, exit icon, and that is exit.png. And then we need to set these icons to the menu items. So let's add them perhaps here. So load item dot set icon. Then we pass in an icon. I'm going to pass in my load icon that I created. And we'll need to repeat the process for the other items. So next we have save item. And this icon is that floppy disk. Save icon. And then exit item dot set icon, exit icon. So now we should have some icons for these menu items. So here we go. We have the three icons that I wanted to use. We can load, we can save, and then we can exit. All right, so in the next video, I'm going to show you guys how we can use the J file chooser class where we can actually select a file, and you can use this as like a backbone if you want. So that's the basics of, what did we cover again? Menu bars, menus, and menu items. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of creating a menu bar in Java.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.